Hello everyone, welcome to basic and applied microbiology classes. Today we will learn about various nutritional types of microorganisms, or we can say classification of microorganisms on the basis of their mode of nutrition. So let's start. So types of microorganisms on the basis of mode of nutrition, this topic we can better understand on the basis of three different criteria. Now question comes, what is criteria? We all know whenever we are learning, we are trying to learn about any type of classification or any type of grouping, always various criteria are used. Similarly, when we are talking about mode of nutrition in terms of microorganisms, then of course various criteria are there, and three different criteria which are very popular to understand this topic I am going to discuss here. So the first criteria is on the basis of carbon, means what kind of carbon source microorganisms are going to prefer for their growth, accordingly we can classify them. Second criteria is on the basis of source of energy, right? On the basis of their preference for different energy sources available, we can make a group of microorganisms. And third, on the basis of electrons, electron source are coming from which type of compounds, again according to this we can classify microorganisms. So let's come again to number one criteria, that is on the basis of carbon. So on the basis of carbon, we can classify microorganisms into two types. First is autotrophs, and second type of microbes are known as heterotrophs. Means autotrophs are having some different carbon compounds preferences, and heterotrophs, they are requiring some another type of carbon source. Now we are talking about second, on the basis of energy. So when we are talking about energy sources, according to energy sources preferences, always remember microorganisms can be classified into two types. First type is phototrophs, and another type of microbes are chemotrophs. Now we are moving towards third criteria, electrons. On the basis of electrons requirement, microbes can be classified as one, lithotrophs, and second, organotrophs, right? So now this is just a superficial information, I can say. We have not gone in depth that when I am going to say carbon source, autotrophs, heterotrophs are the types. This is okay. Energy sources, phototrophs and chemotrophs are the types. Electrons, lithotrophs and organotrophs are the types of microbes. Now question comes, when we are talking about carbon sources, why we are saying these are autotrophs and another group of microbes as heterotrophs? Why one group is phototroph and another group is chemotrophs? So let's start learning about these criteria in detail now. So first, on the basis of carbon source, already we have known about it now. On the basis of carbon source, first type was autotroph and second was heterotrophs. So autotrophs, when we are saying this particular microorganism or these microorganisms are autotrophic types, they are having autotrophic mode of nutrition, or they are autotrophs. Why? Because they can use carbon dioxide as their sole or principal biosynthetic carbon source. Means such kind of microbes are using carbon dioxide as their major source of carbon. Now second type is heterotrophs. Second type of microbes belongs to heterotrophs. What are heterotrophs? Which are not using carbon dioxide, which are using what? Reduced preformed organic molecules from other organisms. Okay, preformed organic substances they can use. Of course, they have already been formed by particular group of organisms. They are already available. Now, let's understand in deep about this. When I am going to say autotroph, they are using carbon dioxide. See, carbon dioxide directly, microorganisms cannot use it when they are interested in deriving energy to carry on their functioning of their cell. So what they generally do, they use carbon dioxide, fix it and convert it into glucose, an organic molecule. After that, glycolytic pathway begins, and then only they can release ATP. They can use various kind of intermediates produced during glycolytic pathway for biosynthesis purpose, right? So autotrophs, remember, when they are going to use carbon dioxide, it is an expensive process for them. It is energy requiring process for them, because first they need to fix it into organic compounds, and then they will be deriving energy from it. Now we are going to talk about heterotrophs. Then heterotrophs are what? They are using preformed organic molecules. Okay, so most of the microorganisms, when we generally talk about pathogens especially, they belongs to heterotrophic types. And when we talk about photosynthetic microbes, then they are lying under which category? Autotrophic type. So now we are moving towards our second criteria, on the basis of energy source. On the basis of energy source, we already know one type was photo and other was chemo. So let's talk about phototrophs. Why we are saying phototrophs? As its name is indicating, they are using light as its major source of energy. And second is what? Chemotrophs. Chemotrophs derive energy from which particular source? Of course, as the name is indicating, from chemical compounds. They can further be of organic type or inorganic compounds. Means from oxidation of organic or inorganic compounds, chemotrophs derive energy. Means they are dependent on chemicals for energy source. That's why we are calling them as chemotrophs. Remember, most of the phototrophs include what kind of examples? Photosynthetic bacteria. And most of the chemotrophs are involved also in elemental cycle of environment, right? So we will be learning examples in detail also. So now we are going towards third criteria. That is on the basis of electron source. On the basis of electron source, again, we are already knowing from our previous slide, lithotrophs and organotrophs. So when we are going to use the term lithotrophs, means this is, the lithotrophs are those organisms which are using inorganic compounds as their electron source. And when we are going to say organotrophs, remember, as the name is indicating, they are going to use organic molecules as their major electron source. So on the basis of electron source, we can again classify microorganisms as lithotrophs and organotrophs. Now question comes, up to this slide we are very much clear that carbon is very important source, energy is very important source, and electrons are very important source. So what comes next, I am going to tell you about is various nutritional types of microorganisms. Again, these were the preliminary understanding of types on the basis of particular source, what I have discussed earlier about on the basis of carbon, electrons, energy. Now remember, when we talk about in nature, how microbes multiply, how microbes persist for a longer period of time, how microbes reproduce, of course, for all that they need nutrition. And nutrition, it can never be only carbon. It can never be only electrons. It can never be only energy sources. Means what? Microorganisms, in order to propagate, require everything. Carbon, electrons, and energy. So remember, when we are going to club all these requirements, on that basis, we can classify some microbes as photolithoautotrophs. Another as photoorganoheterotrophs. Another as chemolithoautotrophs. Then chemolithoheterotrophs. Chemoorganoheterotrophs. Remember, all these types, what I am going to tell you here, are requirement of carbon, energy, and electrons. On the basis of carbon, energy, and electrons requirement, we have classified further different type of microbes into 5 broad categories, right? So when we are saying photolithoauto, somewhat clue we are getting, because we are clear about our basics, that photo is indicating what here? Light. Litho is indicating what? Inorganic. And auto is indicating what? Carbon dioxide as carbon source. So this is indicating what? Carbon sources. What here? Energy is what? And electron sources are coming from which particular source? So on that basis, we can again understand about these 5 nutritional types. This is indicating metabolic diversity among microorganisms. So let's start one by one about these types. So very easily I have tried to show you here. Here again we are going to take nutritional type. We will be taking one by one. Carbon source, what carbon source they are preferring, energy source, electron source, examples of each category. The first type I am going to tell you here is about photolithoautotrophs. So as the name is indicating, if we are talking about carbon source, तो रिमेंबर कार्बन सोर्स विल बी व्हाट ऑफ कोर्स CO2 इन दिस केस ऑटोट्रॉफिक नेचर इज देयर देन एनर्जी सोर्स इफ वी आर सेइंग एनर्जी सोर्सेस फोटो इज देयर इन द नेम सो मींस लाइट इज द सोर्स एंड इलेक्ट्रॉन व्हेन वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट इलेक्ट्रॉन एज द नेम इज देयर इन द फोटोलिथोट्रॉफी लिथो स्टैंड्स फॉर इनऑर्गेनिक इलेक्ट्रॉन सोर्स दे आर रिक्वायरिंग सो फोटोलिथो ऑटोट्रॉफी इफ वी आर नोइंग अबाउट दिस टाइप वी कैन इजिली नो अबाउट इट ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ अवर प्रीवियस नॉलेज वॉट वी हैव गेन्ड थ्रू अवर इनिशियली इंक्लूडेड स्लाइड्स कार्बन एनर्जी एंड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स वॉट आर द पॉसिबल सोर्सेज फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर कैटेगरी एंड वॉट आर द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ दिस सो एज आई हैव टोल्ड यू अर्लियर फोटो मीन्स फोटोसिंथेटिक बैक्टीरिया मेनली पर्पल एंड ग्रीन सल्फर बैक्टीरिया एंड ब्लू ग्रीन एल्गी और साइनो बैक्टीरिया आर एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ दिस कैटेगरी नाउ वी आर गोइंग टूवर्ड्स सेकेंड टाइप सेकेंड कॉम्बिनेशन इज वॉट फोटो ऑर्गेनोहिट्रोट्रॉफ्स सो एज द नेम इज इंडिकेटिंग वॉट यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट हेयर वॉट विल बी द कार्बन सोर्स ऑफ कोर्स ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड बिकॉज हिट्रोट्रॉफ्स आर देयर एनर्जी सोर्स लाइट विल बी देयर इलेक्ट्रॉन सोर्स Of course, most of the times, organo means organic electron sources will be there, organic electron donors, but rarely carbon dioxide can also be used by these bacteria. So this is an exception. What are the examples if we talk about? Purple non-sulfur bacteria and green non-sulfur bacteria are belonging to this particular category. Now remember, when we are talking about photo-organotrophic heterotrophs, these are generally found the purple non-sulfur, green non-sulfur bacteria, we can generally expect the presence of these bacteria in organic compounds, polluted lakes and water streams, right? So now we are going towards next three categories. Again, we have taken the same parameters to understand about these chemolitho autotrophy. Chemolitho autotrophy, as the name is indicating, what we can expect, auto means autotroph CO2. Energy source, chemicals, inorganic chemical sources, they usually prefer electrons, inorganic electron donors, right? And what are the examples of this category? Sulfur oxidizing, hydrogen oxidizing bacteria, methanogens, nitrifying bacteria, and iron oxidizing bacteria. You can see here, most of these bacteria, even I can say all of these bacteria are usually present in what? Biogeochemical cycling. Whenever we study carbon cycle, we always come to know about what methanogens. Nitrogen cycle or always nitrifying bacteria, Nitrosomonas, Nitrobacter are coming, right? So this is about chemolitho autotrophy. Now we are going towards second type, that is chemolitho heterotrophy. Here we are, these are also known as mixotrophs, right? So let's understand about these carbon source, organic carbon, but CO2 may also be used. Why CO2? Because we are saying mixotrophs. Sometimes they follow organic, they can use organic compounds. Sometimes they will be using what? Inorganic, or they can use carbon dioxide as their major source of carbon. Okay? Then we are going towards energy source. In energy sources, inorganic chemicals are generally used by what? Chemolitho. Chemo stands for inorganic chemicals here. Electron source, of course, as the name is indicating, litho, inorganic electron donor. Then why we are going mixotrophs? Because you can see the difference in carbon source category, right? In carbon source category, organic carbon as well as CO2 is mentioned. That's why we call them as mixotrophs. So let's take very good example of mixotrophy. Some sulfur oxidizing bacteria, especially Bagiatoa. Bagiatoa is a mixotroph. And remember, this is a very important question from competitive exams point of view. Mixotrophs, very few bacteria are there which can follow mixotrophy, and Bagiatoa is one of them. Now, third category, chemo-organotrophic heterotroph. In the same way, we can go for it. Carbon source, heterotrophy means organic carbon. Energy source, organic chemicals. Okay, because chemicals are there. Electron source, organic electron donor. Often same as carbon source. Why? Because they are heterotroph, they require organic carbon. And electron source, they can also use the same organic carbon source as a source of their electron donor. Now, what are the examples? Very important examples are included in this category. Mostly non-photosynthetic bacteria. And remember, almost all pathogenic bacteria belongs to chemo-organotrophic heterotrophic category. And fungi, protist, many archaea, they also belong to this category. So I hope you have liked this information what I have shared with you here about classification. Thank you so much. Keep watching and stay connected.